So I'm doing some research on the net, and I'm getting this hesitation problem similar to mine with fuel pressure regulator diagnosis. Here at Planet Isuzu, ISUZOO, I recently noticed hesitation when I accelerate in the mid RPM range on my trooper. Now that's exactly the same problem that I've got. Here at redlinemotive.com, how will I know there is a problem with my fuel pressure regulator? You'll know there is a problem with your fuel pressure regulator from several noticeable symptoms. There will most likely be hesitation during acceleration, and it goes on to say excessive load up during deacceleration, which may cause backfiring or emission. Backfiring I don't have that problem, and you may even experience a choking sensation like the fuel or air is being completely cut off from the motor. Now on one of these forums I noticed that one of the problems was that the engine was completely starved of petrol, and from time to time, not very often, I do have that problem every now and then, that I'll go to accelerate and there'll just be absolutely nothing there and the car will jolt and then get going. Now we're on 4x4wire.com. 2.6 fuel pressure specs. The search is Isuzu 2.6 fuel pressure. Now in summary it says that it should be 35 psi and 42 with the vacuum hose removed from the fuel pressure regulator. So that's sort of 35 to 42. Well, with my tests in the previous videos, I'm pretty sure I'm getting about 30 to 40. Yeah, so that's PSI. The camera seems a little bit fogged up today. I don't know whether that's the screen or not. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, my next move will be to purchase a fuel pressure regulator and install it. We'll see what we get. Okay, so this is a picture of the fuel pressure regulator on my truck. Now, there's the fuel rail, runs along here. The fuel exits the fuel rail, goes down here and starts to travel toward back into the petrol tank. And that's the vacuum line there going for the from the inlet manifold into there. That creates a vacuum and regulates the petrol going from the fuel rail and back to the tank. Interesting story. This is a Beck and Armley fuel pressure regulator. Going back about 8 months to a year, I actually purchased one of these on Amazon and it was faulty. It made the same problem worse. That's a possible clue that this is definitely the part that I need to fix my truck. So I don't know if I was used as a guinea pig or whether or not it was a new faulty product, but I'll try again. Now these fuel pressure regulators are incredibly expensive, very expensive. We've got, this is US dollars of 97, so that'd be about $115-$120 at least, plus $20 US postage, $120, $30, $40, $50, $150 for that little thing. It's only a tiny little, I'll show you a picture of it. So that's it there, a tiny little part. That's the vacuum gauge. That's the where the fuel rail, that's the fuel rail there. The fuel goes along the rail, this regulates the pressure in the rail, and then it exits back in the tank down that pipe there. As seen in the previous videos where I assembled and installed the fuel pressure gauge. So here I found one for $59.80 on Amazon.com, but it can't be shipped to my address because I'm not in the USA. Okay, so that's the cheapest one I can get is $85 US and $21 postage. So 85, 80, 90, 100, 105. So let's say $125 here. So that's gone up $40 to $50 in about a year, a bit less than a year. So while I'm doing my weekend check of my car, where I check my fan belts, my oil, my coolant level, power steering fluid level, brake fluid level, clutch fluid level, and battery and windscreen wiper. I thought what I'd do is check the fuel pressure regulator just by removing this hose here connected to the inlet manifold and seeing if there's any petrol leakage. That's sitting at 20 PSI. So there's no petrol coming out of that fuel pressure regulator. I can't smell any petrol. It seems to be good. However, you probably noticed then that it was idling at 40 psi, where it usually idles at 30 psi. Yeah, it's tough not having a definite, provable point that this fuel pressure regulator doesn't work. Because it's going to cost me about 130, 140 delivered here. So it's tough. I'd say that probably a fuel pressure regulator and a distributor will fix the problem. It's not a huge problem. The car won't break down. It's been going fine for about a year and 3 months. But when I say going fine, I mean just slight annoying hesitation at throttle when under load, going up a hill or whatever. It won't break down. So, it's just a lack of performance. You're going up a hill, you got a lot of new cars with their new engines, the new jet engines sitting behind you, and you're holding up the traffic a bit, but once you get going, you're going at the same speed as everybody else. It's very economical. Probably go for another 3 or 4, 5 years like this. So what's the next direction? It's very hard to tell. Just see what happens. So stay tuned. Anything I find out, I'll post on my video and keep everybody informed.